Kann man das noch mal irgendwo hier nachschauen? Leider natürlich nicht. Schade, obwohl, warte mal, hier. Notes, nein. Ich wollte hier dieses Bild dann nochmal gucken, aber das geht natürlich nicht. Okay, wir speichern mal ab. Also ich glaube ja, dass es dieser Priester ist, weil, ich weiß nicht mehr welcher, irgendeiner von den, nee, ich glaube der Händler war es, hat gesagt, dass wir, irgendwie, ach, was hat er nochmal gesagt, dass es irgendwie Schicksal war, von Gott gewollt oder was weiß ich nicht. Und der Priester war der Einzige, der die Sorge hatte, dass man uns für den Tod verantwortlich macht oder die Gruppe. Also denke ich, dass es der Priester war. Ich glaube auch nicht, dass es die Abenteurerin war. Das kann ich mir nicht vorstellen. Glaube ich irgendwie nicht. Also ich glaube, dass es Parshan ist. The priest does not seem to be surprised by your attack. Aha, and he draws a black sword from beneath his robes. Also hatten wir recht. Oh, der ist aber nicht übel, der Typ. Aber den werden wir schnell kaputt schlagen. Komm, gib mir eine Null. Ja. Naja, damit kommen wir zurecht. Komm. Noch mal einen so einen richtigen fetten Streich. Oh, 4 ist nicht so nett. Oh. Naja, aber wir kommen trotzdem noch gut voran. Gut bei weg. Komm, jetzt noch ein netter Hieb. So, der ist down. Ja, ich wusste es doch. Searching the body, you discover all you need to prove that he was the assassin. Inside his pockets, you find a half-empty vial of Gnadun sap, the deadly poison that was used to taint your food. Then there is a scroll written in Jayak, giving details of your expected arrival in Port Bex. He must have located you at Ragadon and hatched his murder plans there. You notice that the weapon he carries is a Dark Lord blade, fashioned of black steel and forged in the furnaces of Helgedad, the infernal city of the Dark Lords, beyond the Dawncrack range. Only there, in all vast Magnamund, can black steel be made. But the final proof of his true identity is a serpent tattoo on his left wrist. The harbor thugs who attempted to kill you before you had even left Hormgard bore exactly the same mark. His purse contains... Oh! Ja, jetzt sind wir reich. Speichern wir nochmal ab. Wir haben alles gut überstanden. Na. The other travelers stare with horror and disbelief at what you have done. Before you can explain yourself, there is a loud crash at the front door is thrown open. In rush... In rush 6 armored soldiers led by the innkeeper. They are the town guard, and the one-eyed innkeeper is screaming at them to arrest you. Ich glaube, wir verschwinden erstmal. Ich meine, so fit sind wir auch nicht mehr. All through night has fallen, a full moon casts a bright light upon the village. Behind the tavern you see a small wheelwright's shop with two horses hitched to a hay cart. Ich weiß nicht, ob das so vernünftig ist, wenn wir uns drin verstecken. Es ist vielleicht sicherer. Ich speichere nochmal ab. Es ist, glaube ich, sicherer, wenn wir uns eins klauen. Aber vielleicht wird uns das dann noch irgendwie angehängt oder so. Wir verstecken uns einfach mal. You slam the door shut and draw the bolt. The shop is dark, but you can still make out a staircase to your right. A trap door in the center of the floor and another door in the opposite wall. Suddenly there is a crash as an axe splinters a panel of the door behind you. You have been spotted entering the shop and the mob are breaking down the door. Okay, Trapdoor ist nicht so schlau, da wären wir wahrscheinlich in der Falle. Wir verschwinden einfach durch die Tür. As you raise... Oh. Through the door you are knocked off your feet by the force of a spear thrust into your chest. As the moonlight fades, the last thing you see of this world is a cycle of screaming villagers as they step and hack you to death. Ja, okay, sehr schön. Achso, hätte ich gerade nicht abgespeichert? Egal. Okay, dann nehmen wir die Treppe. As you reach the landing of the next floor, you hear the door crash open and the angry mob pour through. At the top of the stairs, a short thought. Nice, jetzt haben wir zwei, jetzt können wir doppelt kämpfen. Oder auch nicht, wir können nur eins equippen. Na egal. Hangs on a hook by the fireplace. You may take this weapon if you wish. Looking around, you see that there is only one way to escape from this room, and that is to jump through the window to the street below. Machen wir das mal. You crash to the muddy street in a shower of broken glass. You are winded by the fall, but otherwise unharmed. An angry villager armed with a cudgel tries to smash your skull, but you roll aside, jump to your feet and sprint away down the twisting street before he has struck his blow. Then an ugly Saul on horseback charges towards you with a raised spear. He is about to stab you when you sidestep and grab the weapon, pulling it and the Saul from the saddle. Okay, den droppen wir. Dann nehmen wir den Speer mit. Und der könnte noch... der könnte sich noch als nützlich erweisen. Wir werden den nicht töten. Nee, das ist unnötig. Wir nehmen sein Pferdchen und verschwinden. You spur the horse along the twisting village streets, across a wooden bridge and up a steep path towards the crest of the cove. In the light of the moon you catch a glimpse of a signpost pointing eastwards, Port Bex. You ride all night without sleep. As the dawn breaks, you are greeted by a startling change of landscape. The barren wildlands have given way to moors and waterlogged fens, and a dark shadow runs the length of the eastern horizon for as far as the eye can see. This is the Durinor Forest, the natural frontier of the mountain kingdom where it borders the untamed wildlands. It is indeed a welcome sight. You are no more than a day's ride from Port Bex, but you are tired after your night ride and you must eat. Ja, ich habe alles richtig gemacht, dass wir es behalten haben. So, jetzt haben wir aber nichts mehr zu futtern. Ups. If you have the key, bla bla bla, you may use skill to trap wild moor rat. Okay, speichern wir wieder. After an hour's ride, you come to a fork in the road. There is no signpost. Tja. Nehmen wir einfach mal den rechten Weg. After a few miles, the track becomes tangled and overgrown until all trace of it has completely disappeared. The ride becomes slow and difficult as you strain to avoid the bogs and potholes of this moor. After several hours, you reach the edge of Durinor Forest, and above the ferns, you notice a tall watchtower. A spiral of smoke rises lazily from a hidden chimney. Machen wir das nochmal. Wir gucken uns das Teil mal an. The area around the watchtower door has been cleared of foliage, and the ground is well trodden. You are looking for a lock or keyhole in the iron-clad door when it suddenly opens. Standing before you is a knight of the White Mountain, a broadsword held in front of his face. State your purpose and mark your words well. My steel will be my answer if you lie. Ich glaube, wir sind da einfach mal ehrlich. The knight sheaths his broadsword and ushers you inside the tower. You follow him to a large room at the top of a flight of stone steps where a log fire blazes warmly. If you are who you claim to be, you must be in possession of the seal of Hammerdal. Show it to me, he orders. Dann tun wir das doch mal. His look of suspicion changes to one of surprise. I believed you to be a trickster, Kylord. I must confess that I had planned to teach you a lesson you would not have forgotten in a lifetime. Please forgive my doubts, but your story sounded so grave that I refused to believe it for fear it be true. I am sworn to the defense of the border, and I cannot leave this tower. But I offer you any of my possessions, if they may aid you on your quest. Oh, das ist natürlich geil. Ich speichere nochmal eben ab. So. Also, wir nehmen natürlich das Geld. Alter, wir sind ja reich wie sonst was. Oh, Healing Potions. Oh, das auch. Hört sich auch nett an. So. Ups. Ich bin ja eigentlich mehr so der Schwertertyp, ne? Aber den Speer, vielleicht kann man den noch irgendwie werfen hier in so einem, in so einer Auswahl oder so. Ich weiß es nicht. Breitschwert. Wir sind ja nun mal hier. Wir kriegen ja hier den Bonus drauf. Meine ich. Und ansonsten. Healing Potion ist natürlich nett. Genau, wir kriegen ja plus 2 Combat Skill. Und deswegen würde ich lieber die benutzen, weil wir haben sowieso schon niedrigen Combat Skill und dann, ja, möchte ich lieber das hier weiterhin nehmen. Und den Speer möchte ich dann behalten. Vielleicht kann man damit noch irgendwie werfen oder sonst irgendwas machen. Das wäre ganz nett. As you are about to leave the tower, he points out the direction you should take. When you reach the Rima Rift, take the track northwards. We'll come to a bridge guarded by the king's men. When they ask for the password, answer them with the word sunset. The road beyond the Rime Rift leads to Port Bags. Godspeed, Lone Wolf. Lone Kicks, I mean. You thanked the brave warrior and leave. You must abandon your horse at the watchtower, for it would be impossible to pass through the dense trees on horseback. Okay. You push on through the dense forest for nearly 3 hours before you discover a track heading north, running parallel to the Rime Rift. Those rushing waters are over 1 mile deep. In the distance, you spot a bridge that spans the dark water at a narrow point. A small hut with a flat roof has been erected at the center, on the top of which stand 2 soldiers. A sign points across the bridge. Naja, wir haben das Passwort und eigentlich dürfte ja nicht schief gehen, oder? Gehen wir mal dahin. The soldiers quickly descend from the roof of the hut and grab their spears. They advance towards you and one of them shouts, Password, stranger. Das kennen wir. The guards reluctantly lower their weapons and allow you to cross the bridge. As you slip past, they stare at you and whisper to each other. Once you are safely across the Rime Rift, you quickly hurry on your way in case they change their minds and arrest you. After nearly an hour of walking along the forest ward, you arrive at a junction where a signpost points to the east. Port Bags, 3 miles. You smile and set off eastwards. You should be there just under an hour. Ja, ich speichere jetzt nochmal öfters ab. Ich muss mal eben was trinken. At dusk on the 10th day of your quest, also wenn schon 10 Tage unterwegs, okay, und wir haben nur 40, das heißt 30 bleiben noch über. You experience your first sight of the magnificent city of Port Bags. Like a diamond set in the green velvet shore, the towers of the city glimmer in the pale light of a waxing moon. To the north is the harbor and formidable war fleet of the Deranese navy. To the east, beyond the moss-covered city wall, stretches the forest of Duranor, and there, on the crest of a hill, stands a castle tall and proud, the crowning glory of this beautiful port. You enter Port Bags through an unguarded gate in the green city wall and make your way through the darkening streets towards the harbor. As you turn into a tree-lined avenue, you notice the white stone steps of a domed building to your right. You stop to read the brass plaque. City Hall. Gehen wir doch mal rein, oder? Just inside the main door sits a kindly old man with a long beard. He is studying a huge leather-bound book that rests on a lectern before him. He has not noticed you enter the city hall. fragen wir ihn nochmal. The Consulate of Summerlund. He says in surprise, somewhat taken aback by your sudden appearance. Then recovering himself, he says, why, of course, it is in Ellen Square, near the harbour. Turn right when you leave and right again at the end of the avenue. That will take you to the Red Gate. You will need a red pass to enter, as the consulate is in the naval quadrant of the city. It's a restricted area. You ask the man how you can obtain a red pass. From the captain of the port watch, he says. You are obviously a stranger to port bags. There are few, indeed, that do not know the answer to that question. The port watchtower is at the end of the avenue, just as you turn for the Red Gate. Okay. At the end of the avenue, the cobbled streets turn abruptly to the right. Opposite this point is a tall white stone building with a plaque above the door. Port Watchtower, Harbour Authority. You can see that the cobbled street ends at a high stone wall. There is a large red gate in this wall, and it is guarded by two soldiers. Beyond the gate you can make out the mast of ship moored in the harbour. Das speichern wir nochmal ab. Wir gehen erstmal in den Watchtower. You are standing in a large empty hall. Opposite are two doors, each with a brass sign above them. Red passes brauchen wir. You enter a large room full of ledgers and files. A man wearing the uniform of a Durinese naval officer is seated opposite at a large desk. He peers at you inquisitively from behind a huge book and says, you must have pressing business in the naval quadrant to apply for a red pass at this late hour. I shall need to see your access papers and proof of your commanding officer's authorization. Hab ich nicht? Probieren wir das mal. The man stares at the seal with a look of shocked dismay. Without saying a word, he gets up from his chair and beckons you to follow him up a flight of spiral stairs that lead to a domed chamber. Here you meet the captain of the port watch. He listens intently as you tell of the war in Summerland and of your urgent mission. Issue a red pass immediately, he orders. Top priority. Geil. So, you collect your pass, leave the port watchtower and hurry along the street towards the harbor guards. Mein Gott, irgendwie habe ich es aber jetzt mit dem Lesen. Wofür der weiße Pass da ist, keine Ahnung. The soldier salutes and allows you to pass through the red gate. You walk into an open square lit by the tall beacons lining the quayside. To your relief, you sight the marble pillars of the Summerland Consulate and the familiar sun flag of your country flying above it in the first night breeze. As you climb the stone steps, you are recognized by the Summerlanding guards on duty at the main door. They disappear inside and quickly return in the company of a tall gray-haired official. His anguished expression suddenly changes to a smile of joy as he beholds you, your wrecked Kyloch and tunic. Hope beyond hope. Thank the gods that you live, Kylord. The scant news that has reached us from the rest has caused us great alarm. You are ushered inside and taken immediately to the envoy of Summerland, Lord Lieutenant Rygar. Mein Gott. Your first meeting with the Lord Lieutenant comes as something of a shock. You had perhaps half expected him to be a servile old man, as are the envoys of the southern lands that plague your king's court with their delegations. The man clad in heavy chainmail standing before you is neither old nor servile. You are soon to learn that Lord Lieutenant Rygar is an exceptional man. Born of a Summerlanding father and a Durinese mother, he has become something of a legend in the city. In the last decade, he has led an alliance of the nations to victory against the invading ice barbarians of Kalte. Wise in peace, fierce in war, you could not have wished for better company on your quest for the summer's word. Riger orders that a sumptuous meal be served. It is by far the best tasted since the war began. During the feast, you recall the events that have brought you to Port Bex and reflect on the daunting challenge that still lies before you. After the meal, Riger sends for his physician, who attends you to your wounds. His potions restore, oh yeah. Then he advises you to sleep, for you are to leave with the Lord Lieutenant for Hammerdal in the morning. Early next day, you are taken to an enclosed garden at the rear of the consulate, where Riger and three of his best soldiers await you on horseback. They are to be your bodyguard and guides on the 230-mile ride to Hammerdal. Ich hab's manchmal so mit Zahlen. Lese ich nicht so oft vor. The streets of Port Bex are just beginning to come to life as you ride through the town. Passing under the moss-covered city gate, you now feel confident that your mission will succeed. Okay, hört sich gut an. Ich mache jetzt nochmal ein Päuschen, weil mein Mund wird gerade sehr trocken. Dann ja, schauen wir, wie es weitergeht. In ein paar Minütchen.